Good morning from Comerica Park, where things are quiet now, and unfortunately for the Tigers, their bats went quiet again in Game 3 last night.
At Ford Field, at Notre Dame Stadium, at Cleveland Browns Stadium, at Soldier Field, at Spartan Stadium, at the Big House. Reporting from the NFL Combine in Indianapolis, in Washington, in Chicago, in Cleveland, in Washington, at Cruz Stadium, at Ford Field, at Comerica Park, at the Nutter Center, in the clubhouse. Dave, there is no faster form of racing than NHRA. We're talking 300 miles per hour. Take a look at this.
Sometimes you can't believe what you just saw or what a replacement ref saw. So many things happen in one sporting calendar or in the 9 seconds after Usain Bolt takes off. And even though things don't always make sense, like a backup quarterback being the most famous player in the NFL or a guy named Bubba winning the Masters, it's always worth watching, especially here in Northwest Ohio. Here's a poetic look back at 2012. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the town, there were sports fans recalling how this year went down. The banners were hung in the rafters with care, in the hopes that more banners soon would be there. For Erik Kynard, it was a silver-filled year. He proved time and again there's no bar he can't clear. A trip to the World Series, then the Tigers went down. They may have a prince, but Miguel won the crown. A title for Perrysburg, their best season yet. Matty Williams kept hitting the back of the net, while Southview advanced on a similar roll, but their season came up a game short of their goal. The Irish are champions, the best in D2, on top of the state and enjoying the view, while Whitmer fought hard, runners-up in D1, the same on the hardwood where the Panthers were stunned. The Falcons are bowling on the way to D.C., which are two of the letters between a B and a G. But three different letters are why Eric Page fell, his NFL shot doomed by his ACL. An undefeated season for the Bucks' Urban Meyer has Columbus fans forgetting about Tressel and Pryor. And the Jamie Farr's back with a champion new, not me, I, or us, but rather, it's you. Kurt Miller's health scare had us doubting his future, but doubt him no more, for today he's a Hoosier. Northview took hockey to unprecedented heights. 5 goals in the finals put the title on ice. Some teams made comebacks. LeBron finally climbed up. There were cups won by drivers, while some needed cups. NAMA came back. The NHL was a dud. The Rockets went bowling in a town known for spuds. All in all, 2012, one of the best years we've seen. Merry Christmas to all. On to 2013. Two states joined by a border, united by a late November hatred. Two teams, two colors, two legendary coaches, a nut and a weasel. The best band, the greatest fight song. The school that gave us Archie, the school that gave us Brady and Brady. On one side, a proven winner coming home. On the other side, a team that hates the color scarlet unless it's on the petals of a rose. Those Wolverines refocused, re-energized after last year's win. The Buckeyes bouncing back better than ever, undefeated. Today, the center of the college football world is in the center of this state. 5 straight times the Wolverines have lost in this stadium. Sure, they've been close, but close only counts in, well, horseshoes. 2 proud traditions, the most Heismans, the most wins. Now, we find out who wants it the most. Two teams, 364 days of preparation. They've crossed their T's and dotted their I's. And now, just like they have 108 times before, the Buckeyes and the Wolverines go to battle. Gotta be honest, it's tough coming up with a new theme every week for Faces in the Crowd, so please excuse my writer's block. I've tried for way too long to come up with a theme this week. I chewed on different ideas, hated them. I took a nap to relax my mind. Didn't work. I thought about smoking to ease my nerves, but I don't smoke. I considered calling in sick to avoid my writer's block, or maybe just make up an excuse like I had a dentist appointment. But then at the station found out they could give me the boot. I mean, lying to my bosses would definitely give them just clause to terminate my contract, or at the very least, chop my paycheck significantly. So I'm toughing it out. It's only one night. So for now, I'll just stick to some bad puns. And hopefully next week, the good ideas will just stick in my head. I've been told that I don't always understand expressions and sayings. I don't know what they're talking about. There's no place like foam. No place like foam. Liar, liar, pacifier. Spikes and stones will break my bones, but white will never hurt me. Better surf than sorry. Don't put all your flags in one basket. You can't teach an old dog new texts. A bird in the hand is worth tattoo in the bush. There's more than one way to spin a cat. It's push up or shut up time. A leopard can't change his socks. Someone got up on the wrong side of the band this morning. So to the people that say I'm confused, whatever, quit making neon jerk reactions. Somewhere in Fulton County, there's a stop sign on State Route 2. Silent, still, foreboding. It was at that sign where two lives stopped on Christmas Eve 2007. That night, a 90-year-old man ran the stop sign and crushed an SUV carrying Elliot Mueller's family, killing his father David and his girlfriend of 2 years, Hollis Reeker.
I think about my father, I think about my girlfriend. When I think of good memories, they used to make me cry because I knew I was never going to have them again.
Elliot and his mother were fine. His brother Brock survived the crash, but with two shattered vertebrae, he was paralyzed and given a 1% chance to walk again.
Was there ever a moment where you said, life's not fair, I'm bitter?
Yeah, I mean, I think I'd be lying to you if I said I wasn't. And there was moments for a while where it dragged on where, I just felt like there was no hope.
The man who hit your family, have you ever spoken to him?
He passed away, I think, about a year later after the accident. He never apologized for it, which is different, and he was given opportunities to with our family there. But, it was an accident. Bless him and his family, because I know it's not easy to probably deal with their side of things either.
Mueller's senior year of high school had started out with so much promise. Just a month earlier, he was named an All-Ohio lineman at Wauseon High School. And when college coaches started showing up to practice, Elliot knew his dream of college football was coming true.
And all of a sudden, Mike DeBoard, offensive coordinator at the University of Michigan, showed up at my high school at Wauseon, and I got to talk to him and everything. And when I left, I asked my coach, I go, did he say Central or Eastern? He goes, no, because that was a Wolverine.
Yes, the Michigan Wolverines were recruiting a lifelong Buckeyes fan. Sure, Elliot dreamed of playing Big Ten football, but that dream was one he and his father shared many Saturday afternoons in Columbus, not Ann Arbor.
Do people give you grief back home about coming up here?
Some people do, but it's really always the people that don't know me. And they probably take it maybe a little further than I would like. But it's funny how it works when all of a sudden, maybe the thing that you've hated and despised and you don't always know a lot about comes up to you and says, we like you. You start to go, you know what, maybe I can like you too.
And so Elliot did what many 18-year-olds do. Graduated high school and moved out of the house, though most aren't lucky enough to move into a big house.
Now you're a freshman, just some kid from Wauseon. Intimidated by the football atmosphere here?
As a recruit, you're kind of blown up to believe, that you're the biggest and baddest thing football's ever seen. And some guys, probably are, but, especially as an offensive lineman coming to Michigan, once I got here, it was an eye-opener.
How have you grown over the past 5 years?
I've been able to meet great people and interact with people that are from Florida and people that talk different than me and maybe have different views and things like that.
Shorter beards.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
But even as life is forever changing, it's tough to forget the night your life was forever changed.
Does losing a loved one make it tough to date in college?
I was kind of going through the life of, I'll never date anyone again, and I'm fine with it, one of those things. And I was fortunate enough to meet someone that I've been with for, over 2 years now.
Your father dies, girlfriend dies, brother paralyzed. You walk away and play college football. How do you wrap your mind around it? Is it fate? Is it luck? What do you think?
I've thought about that. I don't know. I look at my brother especially and see what he goes through, and you can't help but ask, why was it him and why wasn't it me? But I know that I've been blessed, and it's really hard to say, because how can I sit here and say I've been blessed? But Brock was the one that was,
But in many ways since the accident, his brother Brock has been blessed. A lifelong Buckeyes fan just like Elliot, Brock was determined to walk again and prove the doctors wrong, and the University of Michigan was determined to help him.
Up! There you go. Good, Brock. Very good. Come on, three more.
With the assistance of their coaches, training staff, and 33 months of therapy, Brock walked again, leading the Wolverines onto the field in September of 2010.
Ladies and gentlemen, with his mother Shelley and brothers Elliot and Blake, please welcome Brock Mueller.
This past weekend on Senior Day, Brock was back on the field, standing next to Elliot and his mother. The three Christmas Eve survivors who once felt alone, now a support system of 109,000. The family that grew up attending games in Columbus, now feeling at home, surrounded by maize and blue.
Coach, what kind of inspiration and leadership has Elliot Mueller meant to this team?
I think his journey has been one that means an awful lot to the guys on his football team because of how Elliot lives daily, and to overcome the tragedy that he's dealt with in a really first-class way, and just the love his teammates have for him.
Elliot is someone that we're proud to be associated with. He represents us in a wonderful way. He's a fine young man, and Elliot Mueller's the kind of guy that's going to be successful at whatever he decides to do in life.
If 23-year-old Elliot Mueller could go back and talk to 18-year-old Elliot Mueller and give him a heads up on what he needs to know, what would you say?
That's a great question. I think, I guess I would tell him, not to be afraid to embrace everything, where I was at in my life, and just the things I was going through. For me, that would be my message to young Elliot. Don't be afraid to embrace and enjoy finding yourself.
Last month, Erik Page said goodbye to the Rockets and his senior year so he can make himself available for the NFL draft. And all of that starts right here at Lucas Oil Stadium with the NFL Combine.
It was a great experience. It was a great 4 days, and just ready to get back to Toledo.
13ABC spoke with Page after NFL teams finished up their evaluations of the former Springfield Blue Devil.
I had great interviews the whole time. I can't just say one team. It was great coaches, great guys, and I was able to have a great experience in all of them.
Teams poke and prod at players at the combine, measuring everything. Of course, there are the basics such as height and weight. Page checks in at 5'9" and 186 pounds to even the size of players' hands.
They're digging up everything from middle school to high school, everything. So just as long as you have a clean slate, you should be pretty well, and luckily I was.
Even though Page has one of the smallest frames in this year's draft class of receivers, he showed NFL teams he can bench press 225 pounds 15 times. 18 other wideouts could not say the same. On the field, Page had three catches as each receiver runs various routes for the quarterbacks. But in drills you can measure with numbers, 40 guys ran the 40-yard dash. Page had the 30th best time at 4.6 seconds. He had the shortest vertical jump, measuring 30 inches, and cleared 112 inches in the broad jump. That was good for second to last with the receiving group, but while Page's numbers in these events are not where he wants them, he performed very well in the 20-yard shuttle. So well that he clocked a time of 3.98 seconds, the best of the receivers in that event, along with Junior Hemingway from Michigan, who recorded the same time.
I think I did great. I mean, I didn't run the best 40 that I thought I could run, but I ran one of the best short shuttles since 2006, and I think I had a pretty good day catching the ball and running routes. The short shuttle, I knew I was going to do well going into it and was able to do the best in that here.
Now that Page has what the locals call the oil barrel behind him, he'll head back home to Toledo for more workouts as he preps for his March 13th Pro Day on the campus of the University of Toledo, as NFL teams will have another chance to see what this former Rocket is all about. Reporting from the NFL Combine in Indianapolis, Steve Slifka, 13ABC Action Sports.
ABC, the only station in Boise with the Toledo Rockets as they get ready for the famous Idaho Potato Bowl. Joe Nugent with a live report from Bronco Stadium. Joe?
Dave, turns out what's old is new again. More question marks at quarterback for Toledo. Remember, Austin Danton played the season finale for a banged-up Terrence Owens. Well, guess what? Now both of them are healthy.
We'll probably make a final decision on that tomorrow. Fortunately for us, we've had Terrence back. Terrence was able to practice this week, which is great for us. But both Austin and Terrence have both gotten reps with the ones, and we'll probably sit down and make a final decision about that tomorrow. But I would expect to see both playing in the football game.
From Utah State's perspective, they don't care who starts, saying both UT quarterbacks execute the offense in similar ways.
They do stretch it, and of course they're balanced too. And so I think the main thing is stop the run, and then get them to throw the ball in the air, and then that's. Or, of course, I have fun, and but they're good.
Good coaches, good football team, good players. So there's a lot to worry about.
Is there a Rockets distraction headed in? Reports connect Toledo head coach Matt Campbell to the open Wisconsin job.
No, I have no comment on that. That's something that my sole focus from honestly the time the season ended and we heard about this bowl game is winning this football game.
Tough to tell what's what this time of year, but one thing is for sure, beautiful countryside here in Idaho. Take a look at the distance. The mountains just past the stadium here, Broncos Stadium. Beautiful place. The Rockets, of course, enjoying it. And here's Steve Slifka with one of those guys hoping to get a win here on Saturday.
Jermaine Robinson here, of course, a big game against Utah State Saturday. What concerns you about them?
They got a lot of concerns. They got a great quarterback, great running back, some big-time receivers on the outside end. So, we really got a big task on the defensive hand, containing that quarterback and not letting the running back get in the rhythm in the passing or in the running game because he is their leading rusher and leading receiver. So we got a big task, but I think we prepared real well this week, and we just got to go out there and execute Saturday.
What would a win mean for this team to end the season?
It'd mean a lot to the seniors just to get to hold up that trophy in the middle of the field, and also just to spark all them guys that's coming back, Bernard Reedy, Flew, T.O., to let them know at the end of the year, they ended the year 1-0, and they're starting their season with a win. So it's a great thing to get a win.
And we'll see if these guys are holding up the trophy on the blue field Saturday evening.
And if you're wondering what the white tents are doing on the field, those are logos for the game, getting ready for the Rockets and Utah State. The Aggies ranked number 22 in the country. Dave, that's the story for here. Reporting live at Broncos Stadium, I'm Joe Nugent, 13 ABC Action Sports.
And we'll talk to you guys tonight at 11. We'll be right back.